As I understand it, well, tomorrow's the 30th, which I think everything's closed tomorrow because it's supposed to be Truth and Reconciliation Day. I think that's now an official holiday where everything is supposed to close. I know there's certain businesses that are closed that I've already seen. You know, they put it on the Facebook. So I don't know what Mark plans to do if he is going to put the guys out, but I don't think I'm going to do a whole lot of work tomorrow if that's the case, because I've actually got a bunch of things that I want to watch on YouTube to do with Canadian First Nations, the Rez, and I have, like I say, I have friends on Rez's now, and another one now down in Six Nations Reserve. It's the biggest one here in Canada, I think. That's what we say, right? Six Nations Reserve is the biggest reserve. It's kind of southwest of Toronto. It's outside a place called Brantford. Anyways, I hope to go to the actual reserve at some point because, you know, Luke's down there, so I'd like to visit with him and hang out and stuff. He found a campground nearby Hamilton that is open 365 days a year. Now, like I told him, I said, I'm not going to go sit there in a tent, you know, in the middle of, you know, January minus, well, it doesn't get that cold. He says that, and the same with the snow. He said, like, down here, it's not kind of, you know, up there where you get all the snow. And I'm like, oh. So I'm like, okay, well, I mean, I can handle cold with my big buddy heater and my 20-pound tank is full. And, forgot what I was saying here. I don't think I'm going to jump on Highway 7. I think we're going to take the back way. It's a little longer, but there'll be no traffic, and it's, you know, it's nice. I can film it with you guys, so I don't think I've ever done this this way. Excuse me. With, you know, taking you guys with me. So this is going to be a long one. I'm going to have to split this into three or something. I don't know. But I won't film going back. I'll just film going up. We don't need to film it. You know, the coming back. That lad with a beard there, about 14 miles long. Big old beard on him. I think I was supposed to turn. I don't know. I'm okay. Anyway, lots of deer apples. I gotta text Randy and find out if these guys are coming down this year or not, or what's going on. Because right now is the time for me to be like that. See, that'd be good to add the ATV. I'll just bring, like a 5-gallon pail with me and go out to some of these apple trees. The apples are getting ripe now, so it's a good time to grab them and keep them for the deer feeders. So I've got the new weed whipper, so I'm gonna clean out. I only need to weed whip the ones kind of in the front before the weed patch. The other one in the back, I filmed it, I think, the other day. It doesn't need any weed whipping. It's always exposed. So, but I say it all predicates on whether Randy's coming up, you know, Chris and all these guys, or they're not. I never know each year. Last year, they were all coming up, and then Chris got sick, and then nobody came. So, Mel left a big 60-pound bag of feed, deer feed, like corn with molasses in it kind of thing. And try to remember which way I am going. I think it's this way, Old Perth Road, yeah. So I've got feed, I've got, you know, but apples are the big thing. And it's good to get them on the apples now, so when the boys, if they shoot one, assuming, you know, the deer that they shoot has been eating the apples, I find it makes the meat tastier. And people go, well, no. I'm like, well, how come we used to feed, we would feed pigs a good week or two before we slaughter, and we would just be pounding the apples to them, which of course they love the apples, not knowing that that was their, you know, gonna meet their end. And The meat would taste different from the ones we didn't feed the apples. Better taste. I don't know, not sweeter. I wouldn't want to describe it like that. Just a better taste. So, but it does the same for the venison. So, I think that's my turn right there. Yeah. Forest Road. Is that the name of the road? I don't remember this. Well, we're on what we call a Chappie Adventure. It's not a dead end, so unless they change the name of the road, because this looks like the road I usually take, but before, I didn't even know it was called Forest Road. Anyway, doesn't matter. I'm enjoying the drive. The noise you hear is wind noise. I've got the window open on the passenger side and then the other one behind me. So, because it's nice, I don't want to run AC, obviously, and I obviously don't want to run heat. It's 22 Celsius today, so, who knows, this is the right place. Just turns back into Old Perth Road, okay. I've never even looked at it, Forest Road. See, there's one of those roads for the ATV ride, and, you know, there's no, township doesn't take care of that road in the wintertime, so... Yeah. I guess that spilled me okay. You guys can see all right there? Yeah, I guess so. This will be the longest coffee with the V-Lad. V-Lad. Coffee with the V-Lad! Yeah, that's it. V-Lad. Coffee with... This will be the longest one. I'll be splitting this into two, so... Oh, I'm not turning here. What are you doing? You gotta go straight, mister. Oh, he's obviously on the phone. He just swerved almost into the ditch. Well, he's got both hands on the steering wheel. That's okay. You guys could probably see it. He swerved into the ditch and then swerved back out. Oh, well. I'm not driving his truck, so who knows, but he had both his hands on the steering wheel. It was very obvious. I didn't, of course, because I had a cup of coffee, because I'm doing what? Coffee with the lad vlog. Or lad from the woods, coffee vlog? No. Coffee with the lad vlog. Isn't that what I call it? Jesus, Murphy. Eh? See what happens at 61 and you know? I'd say that's a warning to you kids, but there's not supposed to be any kids on my channel, so I don't do the 18 and over thing because we're not that far over. So, but I mean, you guys will see. I mean, there's always the restricted thing, so, but anyway. It's a piece of me I don't really care. I will never quit doing that. If I can't do it that way, then these pens, which I'm really on to now, and then of course there's gummies and shit like that. So and now we go into the shady part. God, there's a lot of people. For sale signs everywhere, eh? The market's gone crazy here. Even my mother asked me the other day, she said, what did the neighbor get for that place? And it was, I said, well, $948,000. So I don't know why she was asking. She might be starting to think that, well, maybe it's time to sell and she's going to go live, you know, in the adult complex in Elmont or something. She knows that I don't need a place to live because I'm just, you know, even while I wait for the bus to get built, you know, because I'm going to get that 27 footer that Luke is talking me into, and I'll just buy an RV temporarily, live in it, and then the bus is done, and then that's that, and then I'll decide from there what I'm going to do. Lots of different options. There's maybe you look at a place in Cocoa Beach. Jesus Christ, why would have I ever said Cocoa Beach? I'll explain in a minute. I just slow one down. Cocoa Beach in Florida used to be where my grandparents owned a condo, and it was right on A1A. This was before they built all these condos right on the beach, so they were across A1A, and behind them was the Banana River or Indian River, whatever. So it was like that. And this condo complex, I don't know, there might have been like a dozen condos in it. It was all people that knew each other, my grandparents and their friends, and you know, another, you know, aunt, uncle, whatever. And of course, we were all welcome to go there. And the first and only time I ever went to Florida, because I'll never go back there, was when I was 18, 1980. My friend Andy and I drove down there in a beat up old Toyota Corona, not Corolla, a 1971 Toyota Corona, which promptly broke down on the way down. So we went through all that. And anyway, we got there and we did have a good time, but the heat and the humidity and just everything's like, wow. I didn't like swimming in the ocean because you had to go shower every time. You know, because of the salt. And then, you know, oh, you got to watch for jellyfish. You got to watch for sharks. I'm like, fuck, man, I'm a Great Lakes guy. I don't need this shit. You know, like, there's nothing in the Great Lakes that I'm aware of anyways, all the years I've swam in it. You know. Who knows what lives down, say, 1,000 feet at Lake Superior. Probably not a whole lot. The water's very, very cold down there. Anyways, yeah, so I just didn't like it. The drive down there on that I-95, there were fires when we were down there. I didn't know until after I got down there that you're not supposed to walk through the sides of the road to go grab oranges off a tree, because that's, first of all, it's private land. But then you discover, oh, well, there's alligators or crocodiles, whatever, you know, the Godzilla looking things all living in these places. That's what keeps people from stealing the oranges. And anyways, we didn't get bit or anything like that, but it was like, holy moly, man, this place is like a nightmare, you know. And then there was all kinds of other things. There was these huge, I don't know whether my grandpa used to call them shit bugs or something. I mean, these things are like right out of a horror movie. No, I mean, they don't bite or anything. I mean, I saw them, but I'm like, I'm not scared of insects or anything. I mean, my favorite, I have like a favorite insect, which are dragonflies. I absolutely love those things. They're just so cool. But anyhow, yeah, so I never enjoyed that. This just wasn't my thing. So I never went back, and I don't intend to go back. And then, you know, as recent events have proven, Hurricane Helene, I mean, it just smashed everything in the upper part of Florida into North Carolina. Then it wound up in Kentucky. Then it hit the Appalachians. Not the area, though. I got to talk about that later. But I found an area that I want to go camping and hanging out in the Appalachians when I go visit my friend in D.C., because it's way up in the mountains there, like 5,000 feet up, so the temperatures don't get stupid. It is rainier and foggier because of the way the mountains are, but that's okay. I'm okay with all that. And what was the other thing? Oh, yeah. I saw a report on the news that somewhere in Appalachia, it was starting to flood there. So, I mean, it's bad. And that's still going on right now. Like, the hurricane's over, but it's like now tropical depression, but the rain has been nuts. And, I mean, you have to see the video, I mean, of what happened. It's bad. Anyways, I would say that one place, North Carolina, that's their version of, you know, Katrina. Like, seriously, guys. Is this my road? No, that isn't my road. 7A, I got a ways to go yet. So this area that I had scoped out is like 2.5 hours from where Elsie lives in DC, and So it's like, I told her, I said, like, if I'm down there visiting you and I want to get out of that city because I'm going nuts or whatever, you know, and I mean, it's not a long drive. I just throw my tent and everything. Well, I'll bring my camping gear with me. And there's camping spots. I even looked at a piece of property down there that's for sale. Like I've been telling her, I probably shouldn't say anything, but boy, property prices up in the real deep Appalachia places like I was looking at. I can't remember. I can't even pronounce the name. There's like a big national park there, but it's on the border from West Virginia to the other state that's like got Washington in it. I don't know which state that is. Maryland, I guess. Anyways, but there's like a number of national parks, but there's private land all up in there as well. And I found one piece of land that I'd take tomorrow if I knew everything about it. The guy's only, it's 7.5 acres. It's nobody, I mean, there's nothing around there. There's a nice big creek, kind of creek river running through it. Doesn't freeze in the winter. It's like you got everything you could ever possibly need there to survive, even in a, you know, a bad event or, you know, another COVID nonsense thing, whatever. Oh, I'm not supposed to be doing 80 here. This is only 60 kilometers. So I was like, wow. And then I looked when the guy had put it up for sale, and it was like this summer, he put it up in, well, he or she put the place up for sale in July, and it's still there on the realtor's site. I'm like, okay, people aren't jumping on that. But see, that's the whole point, is this place, you know, up in the Appalachia, way up in there, 5,000 feet, people don't want to be there. Well, that's, you know, I look at it, and it looks like Canada to me. You know, the big mountains and the water and the hills and, you know, the creeks and all that stuff. So I didn't happen to notice that there was a lot of lakes around there, but compared to here, there's never going to be anything in the United States that compares to where I live, you know, in Canada here, where we have, they said, I heard the other day somebody estimated we had 1 million lakes in Canada. And I said, well, that would probably match, because in my area, they, you know, Land of Lakes, they call it 10,000, there's 10,000 lakes. And I've had conservation officers say that they've done surveys, you know, and one of them, I've said the story, one of them joked around with me about, well, Big Pal, if you were to fish one of these lakes every day, in order to be able to do the all of them in our region, it would take you 13 years. And that's assuming that you can even get to them all, which you cannot. So there's some that you can only get there in the winter on the ATVs. I've been there, ice fished. Hopefully we're going to do that again this winter. I'm hoping, if the boys are feeling, last year they wanted to go out. So, and I'm going to have a new ATV by then. Let's pull the pin, whatever. I'm going to go get one of these ATV loans, bad credit ATV loans. And because of the money I got coming in from Mark, I can show them that documentation. And I'm going to go get me, I've decided on a Suzuki King Quad. And that's because the boys down at Sable Beach Motorsports talked to me about it. True has said, oh yeah, that's a very good decision. And the King Quad that I was looking at is exactly what I need. It's, you know, part work bike, part enduro, like racing, but not racing, you know, like, so what we would call an enduro. And it's a perfect bike, absolutely perfect. So I'm gonna pull it and get that thing. So I'm gonna have a new bike for ice fishing this year. So I'm hoping these guys are gonna wanna go. Which reminds me, I'm going to have to start going through the ice fishing equipment now to make sure it's up to date, like I've done with the saltwater fishing equipment. But yeah, I'm going to do that. I really don't want to, but because of the insurance rates and everything. But then, you know, True and I were talking, he's like, well, you know, if you, when you go to sell that property, he says, you can go ahead and pay that off, and then, you know, you won't be paying all that huge interest because it'll be paid off early. I'm like, oh, that's true too, eh? So I think that's the way I'm going to go. And then, you know, whenever the big day comes, I put everything for sale. So when I text Randy, I'll text Kurt at the same time, and I'll say, listen, what's happening? Are you guys coming up here to hunt this year? Are you going to be at Betty Ford? Maybe I'll come visit you guys up there while you're doing that. I just trying to get these guys to go out and then go see them myself and visit. Even if I just sit there and smoke a doobie with them, I don't care. Well, this guy's got his trailer all put together, kind of like what we're going to do with my trailer. This guy's riding my ass. He thinks it's 80, but it's not. It's 60 here. So, and I won't speed. One time when I was younger, always in a panic, but I don't do that anymore. I'm going to shut you guys down here shortly because we're going to be coming into Carlin Place and I don't need to film, you know, going into Walmart. So, yeah, try and get these guys motivated, because if they're motivated, then I'm motivated, kind of thing, you know? Like, you're like, okay, the boys want to go. Last year, when they called me to go ice fishing, my bike had broken down. Just had broken down like 3-4 days before that. And I had to tell him, I can't. I said, the bike's broken, and I True had it, and he hadn't got working on it yet. So, well, there we are, cabin all concrete. That's where Kurt happens to work. They're closed today, but that's one of the lads I'm talking about. This is where he works. Well, somebody, well, I thought somebody was in one of the trucks. I'll say there shouldn't be anybody in those trucks today. So we'll see what happens with that. So that's about it, man. 43 minutes. So I guess that'll be two 20-minute videos for the vlog. I'll call this road vlog or something. Copy with the lad road vlog, and then there, it'll be, it'll make me feel better about it being so long, because I really don't like doing it this long. I can see the time. I've got time to turn left as long as I don't have anybody. Okay, we're good to go. So, yeah, let's end this. Yeah, so like the usual, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for coming. Always look forward to your comments as well. Hey, that home that my mother's thinking about... No, this is Carl Place, wrong town. I say, because I know the home that she likes. We could have driven by it, but I didn't go that way. Anyway. Anyways, please like, share. It's big stressful. I just, the whole idea of my mother going into one of these places just really upsets me. But even now, I mean, she's asking about, you know, the neighbor's property, what it sold for. I think her headspace is going there, and her memories dropped a lot. So anyways, please like, share, and subscribe. A comment, please, 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 please. I enjoy them. And thank you for coming, as always. And yeah, you guys want to help out with the channel or cats, for the cats or anything like that, there's paypal.com/ladfromthewoods. buymeacoffee.com/ladfromthewoods. Also, I'm over on Rumble, Lad from the Woods. And yeah, that's it, man. So be good to your fellow humans, and peace, long life, and live long and prosper.